rarely will do a pencil paper activity. I only have kids for 50 minutes, once every 6 days, and so everything we do is on purpose. I learned this activity really through a clinician that I saw it, and we have a really great resource here at Currington that a lot of other schools don't have, in that we have a drum for every student. So we can set up 23 drums in the classroom and have plenty for kids to use. So I use drums because they're fun for kids. It takes them right where they're at. They don't use them as as an everyday activity, so it's something different and unique and fun.
What's your favorite part about music class?
And actually listen to the music. Listening to the beats and paying attention. So it's funner and so you don't get bored.
That whenever we play drums, we get to learn the notes of the music that we're playing. Like a certain beat, and then we get every time, whenever that beat's done, we get to move to the next drum and then do it on that beat. And then whenever we move like 4 or 5 times, then we get to do like 3 on our drum, and then we get to hit the other person's drum.
Learning music early plants a seed of being a creative thinker and using our brain in multiple ways, not just in the classroom. A lot of times can use a left brain, but we are using the right brain and the left brain because we're using sight, sound, movement. It's really great because our bodies learn more when it's moving anyway. So we get kids to move it, to feel it, to think for themselves, not to follow each other. But it's a lifelong skill that they're building, not just for music class, but for other things. The beauty of being a music teacher is that I see these kids from 1 year to the next. So I've built relationships with some of these kids since they were in kindergarten, some even in pre-K here at our school. So I know their families, I know them from when they're babies, and when they graduate, so to speak, in fifth grade, I will have seen them for 6 straight years. We use a song that they're familiar with so that when they're playing complicated patterns, then they understand where it's coming from and they can hear it a lot better because it's innate in them. They already know the song, so they're hearing complicated patterns, they're playing complicated patterns, but they do it instinctively without me even telling them because it's part of the song that they already know. So that connects the rhythm to what we do in music class to real life, which is the key to what we want them to do, because we really want them to learn music, we want them to learn patterns, but we really want them to ultimately love music forever. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3.